Good morning, students. Today we are going to start chapter 2 of Moments. The name of the chapter is The Adventures of Toto by Ruskin Bond. In this chapter, we'll see how Toto, a baby monkey, is indulged in various type of adventures and how these adventures are faced as a problem by the narrator and his family members. So, let's start the adventure of Toto. The chapter starts with asking a question. Have you ever had a baby monkey as a pet? Toto is a baby monkey. So, this question is asked, and the answer we have to find out in the chapter which follows. Grandfather bought Toto from a Tonga driver for the sum of 5 rupees. Means the narrator's grandfather bought a Toto, a monkey, from a Tonga driver for a sum of 5 rupees. The Tonga driver used to keep the little red monkey tied to a feeding trough, and the monkey looked so out of the place there that grandfather decided he would add the little fellow to his private zoo. When the grandfather saw the pathetic condition of Toto to his previous master, who was a Tonga driver, he purchased Toto from the Tonga driver and decided to make Toto a part of his private zoo, which he used to have. Toto was a pretty monkey. His bright eyes sparkled with mischief beneath deep-set eyebrows, and his teeth, which were pearly white, were very often displayed in a smile that frightened the life out of elderly Anglo-Indian ladies. Over here, the narrator describes the physical appearance of Toto. As Toto is a pretty, beautiful baby monkey, but his eyes are sparkling due to mischief, and his teeth are pearly white, white as a pearl, and they are so much dangerous looking that ladies coming to narrator's house are afraid of them. But his hands look dried up as though they had been pickled in sun for many years. But the hands of the baby monkey were so dried as if they were dried pickles for many years. Yet his fingers were quick and wicked, but the fingers were quick in mischief. And his tail, while adding to his good looks, and his tail, as we know, a favorite part of a monkey body. Grandfather believed a tail would add to anyone's good looks. And it was the belief of grandfather, thought by the narrator, that a tail to anybody would be an advantage to his look. It also served as a third hand for a monkey. He would use it to hang from a branch, and it was capable of scooping up any delicacy that might be out of reach of his hands. And the tail used to help him to hang on the branches and to pick up anything which was not possible to pick up by his hands. Grandmother always fussed when grandfather brought home some new bird or animal. The grandmother of the narrator always used to get angry on grandfather whenever he used to bring any sort of pet animal to his private zoo. So it was decided that Toto's presence should be kept a secret from her until she was in a particularly good mood. So it was decided by the narrator and his grandfather to keep a secret that Toto should be hidden from grandmother's view unless and until her mood was in a favorable situation. Grandfather and I put him away in a little closet opening into my bedroom wall. The narrator and his grandfather kept the pretty monkey, baby monkey rather to say that, in a small room attached to the room of the narrator, where he was tied securely, or so we thought, to a peg fastened into the wall. The narrator and his grandfather tied the little mischievous monkey to a peg which was tied in the wall. A few hours later, when grandfather and I came back to release Toto, we found that the walls, which had been covered with some ornamental papers chosen by grandfather, now stood out as naked brick and plaster. When the narrator and his grandfather returned to the room where Toto was kept, they found Toto missing, and the wall over there, which was decorated by ornamental papers, were being removed, and the plasters on the wall and the bricks were seen literally. The peg in the wall had been wrenched from its socket. The peg which was in the wall through which the monkey, baby monkey, was tied was removed, and my school blazer which had been hanging there was in shreds, and the school blazer of the narrator which was hanging there was torn to pieces. I wondered what grandmother would say. The narrator thought what would be the reaction of grandmother after seeing all this. But grandfather didn't worry. He seemed pleased with Toto's performance. But the grandfather was totally happy with seeing over there what had been done by the mischievous baby monkey Toto. "He's clever," said grandfather. "Given time, I'm sure he could have tied the torn pieces of your blazer into your rope and made his escape from the window. Over here, we can see that." Grandfather is appreciating the baby monkey. He said, "If Hugh had been given a time, he would have tied the pieces of the blazer into a rope and might have escaped from the window. His presence in the house still a secret. His presence was kept a secret." Toto was now transferred to a big cage in the servants' quarter, where a number of grandfather's pet lived very sociably. Pet was transferred to the place where others' pet used to live together as a family member, as friends. A tortoise, a pair of rabbits, a tame squirrel, and for a while, my pet goat. The animals kept over there were a tortoise, pair of rabbits, squirrel, and a pet goat of the narrator. But the monkey wouldn't allow any of his companions to sleep at night. But the mischievous baby monkey didn't allow any of the members to sleep at night. So grandfather, who had to leave Dehradun the next day to collect his pension in Saharanpur, Next day, the following day, grandfather has to leave Dehradun to Saharanpur to for his collection of pension. Means, over we here we can see that the narrator was from Dehradun. So, the grandfather decided to take him along. So, it was decided that the secret should not be revealed and the other pets should stay calmly. So, grandfather decided to take Toto with him to Saharanpur. Unfortunately, I could not accompany grandfather on that trip. But something unfortunate happened, that the narrator was not able to accompany his grandfather to Saharanpur. But he told me about it afterwards. But the trip was narrated by the grandfather to the narrator after coming back. A big black canvas kit bag was provided for Toto. A big canvas bag was provided for Toto so as to keep him and taking away to Saharanpur. This with some straw at the bottom became his new abode. In the new kit bag, some straw were put so that Toto would be comfortable over there. When the bag was closed, there was no escape. The bag was closed and Toto would not be able, as thought, to come out from the bag. Toto could not get his hands through the opening and the canvas was too strong for him to bite his way through. As thought, Toto would not be able to make his hands out from the bag and the canvas bag was so strong that Toto would not be able to tear it off. His efforts to get out only he had the effect of making the bag roll about on the floor and occasionally jump into the air. Toto tried occasionally to come out or to get rid of the bag. He rolled inside the bag, making the bag roll itself. An exhibition that attracted a curious crowd of onlookers on the Dehradun railway platform. And that activity of Toto of rolling and jumping into the air made the canvas bag to roll and jump into the air attracted many co-passengers on the Dehradun platform. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur. Until they reached Saharanpur, Toto was calm and quiet in the bag. But while grandfather was producing his ticket on the railway turnstile, Toto suddenly poked his head out of the bag and gave the ticket collector a wide grin. At the Saharanpur railway station, when grandfather was showing his ticket to the ticket collector, Toto came out from the bag and gave a big grin, a big smile to the ticket collector. The poor man was taken aback. Means the ticket collector was surprised. But with a great presence of mind and much to grandfather's annoyance, he said, "But over here, the ticket collector showed his presence of mind, which made grandfather annoyed. He said, "Sir, you have a dog with you. You will have to pay for it accordingly." The ticket collector said that the grandfather was carrying a dog with him and he had to pay the fare of the dog also. In vain, grandfather took Toto out of the bag. In vain did he try to prove that a monkey did not qualify as a dog or even as a quadruped. Grandfather tried to make understand the ticket collector that the baby monkey never looks like a dog, neither he qualifies to be a quadruped, but it was totally in vain. Toto was classified a dog by the ticket collector, and 3 rupees was the sum handed over as his fare. But the ticket collector was not going to listen to grandfather's views, so he gave a charged a fare of 3 rupees, which the grandfather had to hand it over. So let's keep it till here. Further we'll proceed in the next video. Thank you.